So let's review a little bit. The main idea here is molar concentration. So what is molar concentration? Another term for this is molarity. This is the amount of solute molecules or formula units in moles present in a given volume of the solution in liters. So moles and liters are your main units here. So if we're gonna break this down a little bit, your basic equation is molarity equals moles per liter. And I want you guys to be aware that moles per liter are the main units, but you can also define molarity with the units of millimoles or micromoles. So just be aware of that and make sure you know how to convert back and forth. If you're given a value that is a mass in grams of an element or a molecule, you can convert this mass to moles by using the molar mass. Let's look at this example. So to convert grams of carbon to moles of carbon, we use the molar mass. This value is taken from the periodic table. 12.01 grams of carbon are in every 1 mole of carbon. That means that in 24.02 grams, we have 2 moles of carbon. So just make sure that your units cancel here. Grams and grams are canceling to yield moles. So why is this even important? Remember, we're using molar concentrations of dissolved substances to quantitatively analyze solutions. Also, molar concentration is important for dilution calculations, and this has a direct lab application. Here's a problem you might get on a test or in your homework. A solution is prepared by dissolving 55.1 grams of potassium chloride in approximately 75 milliliters of water. And then adding water to a final volume of 125 milliliters. What is the molarity of potassium chloride in this solution? So here in red, I have the given information and also what we're solving for. So we're solving for the molarity of potassium chloride. And just notice also that the values are given in with 3 significant figures. So when we have our final answer, we want to make sure to include 3 significant figures. First, we need to find the molar mass of potassium chloride. We know from the periodic table that in 1 mole of potassium, there are 39.1 grams, and in 1 mole of chlorine, there are 35.45 grams. So we basically just add these together to get a molar mass of potassium chloride is 74.55 grams. Now we need to calculate the number of moles in potassium chloride. So we're given that there are 55.1 grams of potassium chloride, and we take the molar mass, which we calculated in step 1 as the denominator of this fraction, and once you punch that into your calculator, you'll get that we have 0.739 moles of potassium chloride. So to calculate molarity, again, let's look back at our equation. Molarity is equal to moles per liter. So we just calculated that there are 0.739 moles of potassium chloride. And the problem tells us that there are 125 milliliters. It's just 10 to the negative third. So we have 0.125 liters. This is given. So dividing moles per liters, we end up with a final answer. A molarity of potassium chloride equal to 5.91 moles per liter. And again, notice that we have our answer here in 3 significant figures to match what was given in the question. Okay, so we're going to move on to the last example here, which is going to be a dilution calculation. So it's important to remember that when diluting a solution, the moles of solute always remain the same. The formula you're going to need here is M initial times V initial equals M final V final, or M1 V1 equals M2 V2. Now, your M is just your molarity, V is volume. So your initial molarity times your initial volume is equal to your final molarity times your final volume. So this is going to be for solution 1, and this is solution 2. What volume of 0.0380 molarity of potassium permanganate is needed to prepare 250 milliliters of 1.5 times 10 to the negative third molarity of potassium permanganate? We know that the first molarity is equal to 0.0380 moles per liter of potassium permanganate. The second molarity given is 1.50 times 10 to the negative third, and the final volume value is 250 milliliters, which we know just converts to 0.250 liters. So the only unknown here in the equation M1 V1 equals M2 V2 is V1. We can say that M1 V1 equal to M2 V2 can be rearranged to V1 equals M2 V2 over N1. All you have to do is plug in the given values. So V1 equals M2, this is the M2 value, which we said right here. So this is going to be the molarity of the final solution. V2 is 0.250 liters, and M1 is the initial molarity. So when you calculate that, V1 is equal to 9.87 times 10 to the negative third liters. So for a dilution problem, if you're in the lab and you need to dilute a stock solution to a different concentration, in this case, 9.87 milliliters of the solution should be measured into a 250 milliliter volumetric flask. And then you would add water up until the 250 ml mark to get your diluted solution. Don't think about it, just move your body. Listen to the music, sing oh, hey, oh. Just move those left feet, go ahead, get crazy. Anyone can do it, sing oh.